Good morning, everyone. So glad you could join me today. Today's class is to help get us grounded, get us feeling connection with the earth, feeling rooted and centered. So find yourself in a comfortable position, sitting down. You can have your legs outstretched, or you can cross them like I have mine. Whatever feels best for you. The most important thing here is to feel your sits bones on the earth, on the mat, and to reach the spine up nice and long, getting your head up towards the sky. We're going to take a moment with our eyes closed, just to go inside. So close your eyes, feeling your sits bones on the mat, on the floor, feeling your spine extending up, your head rising up towards the sky. Noticing if you have any tight spots, any tension, and allowing those areas to soften. And then becoming aware of your breath. Maybe feeling the cool air flowing in and warmer air flowing back out. As you breathe in, breathing all that air down into your belly, into your lower abdomen, feeling it expanding. And as you exhale, feeling that abdomen sinking back in, feeling yourself maybe sinking a little bit deeper into your sits bones. As you inhale, expanding, maybe reaching the top of the head up towards the ceiling or the sky. Exhale, relaxing, sinking deeper towards the earth. Feeling that connection with Mother Earth. And from here, let's let our hands rise up towards the sky. Breathing in, getting nice and long. And then bring your fingertips together as you exhale. We'll allow those hands to gently float down to your heart center, connecting with that heart, with your love. And you can close your eyes here, bringing to mind a thought of gratitude. A lot of times when we are not feeling grounded, it's because we're not in the moment. And to come to a thought of gratitude will help to bring you back into this moment. Just being grateful for breathing, being grateful for turning on this class, being grateful for your body. And then just bowing your head down towards your fingertips, just to let the back of the neck stretch out. And then slowly lifting your nose up towards the sky, feeling the front of your throat and your neck stretching out. And then slowly bringing your head back to its natural position. We're going to take our fingertips and bring them down to the floor. feeling your fingers resting on your mat. And then reaching the left arm all the way up, nice and big. Stretch. We're going to do a little side body stretch here, keeping your sits bones where they are and slowly coming over to the side, breathing into that space. And then coming back to center. Beautiful. Let's reach the other arm up. Reaching it up a little bit higher, keeping your sits bones down and slowly coming over to the other side. Taking a few moments to breathe here. And then coming back to center. Beautiful. Taking your shoulders and bringing them up to your ears, rolling them down your back. Sitting up nice and tall, and with your sits bones where they are, let's take the left hand to the right knee. Taking your right hand behind, nice gentle twist here. So just twisting from the shoulders down your spine. Breathing all the way back down towards your belly. And then coming back to center, let's go over to the other side, taking that right hand to the left knee, left hand behind, nice gentle twist, opening the shoulders and then gradually twisting a little further down. As you breathe all the way down into your belly, just giving your internal organs a little massage. And then coming back to center. We're going to come onto our hands and knees and coming into child's pose. So you can take your knees a little further apart, bringing your toes together, maybe resting your hips onto your heels, and then stretching your arms out towards the front of your mat. Letting your head come down. If it doesn't quite reach the floor, you can stack your fists. Most important thing here is to make sure you feel supported. So when we're not feeling grounded, a lot of times it's because we aren't feeling supported. And just know that the earth is always there to support us. Breathing all the way up the back of your body. And just letting go. With each exhalation, feeling yourself sinking deeper towards your mat. Letting go a little bit more. Softening.
From here, we're going to come up back into our little table position, but we're going to actually bring our feet onto the ground and coming into a little froggy pose. So playing around here, if your heels don't touch the mat, that's quite all right. Just rocking back and forth, getting your hips a little bit closer to the mat, a little closer to the earth. Gently and easily. And if you can get one heel down at a time, perfect. Just working on eventually being able to get both heels down. And if your heels are up, that's okay. You can keep your hands in front of you for support. And noticing where you might be holding tension, allowing that to soften. And if you feel comfortable, maybe bringing your hands back to your heart. Taking a moment to feel this pose. It's a deep hip opener, making sure your knees aren't screaming at you. Coming back to your breath. This is really good for allowing our digestive tract to work better for us. Good pose to come into. From here, let's bring our hands back down to the mat if they're not there already. We're going to lift the hips up towards the ceiling and just coming into a little rag doll. You can wiggle your feet together a little bit more, letting your head hang down. If your lower back is tender today, you might want to keep your knees a little bit bent. Maybe swaying from side to side, getting loose and limp. Coming back to center, back to stillness. Maybe wiggling your feet in a little bit closer together so they're right underneath your hips. We're going to bend the knees very generously and slowly and gently, feeling your feet on the mat nice and solid, we're going to bring ourselves up very, very slowly, keeping your chin tucked until you're feeling stable. And when you're feeling stable, let's lift the head up, letting those shoulders relax back down. So coming into mountain pose. So mountain pose, we usually rush through mountain pose. We're going to take some time here. So just rocking back and forth on your feet. We're going to start with our foundation. So feeling your feet on the mat, rocking back and forth. Maybe lifting your toes and your heels. And then allowing yourself to settle. Allowing those feet to rest comfortably on the mat. Noticing which parts of your feet are touching the mat. Maybe having that nice little arch. Feeling the balls of your feet and the heels, maybe the outsides of your feet, and then your toes maybe gripping a little bit onto the mat. And then we'll work our way up, so above the feet or your ankles, and then setting your knees up above your ankles. So you might want to bend your knees and then straighten them. Setting your hips up over your ankles. Shoulders can come up to your ears and roll down so that they're over top of your hips. And then your ears, you want those over top of your shoulders. And we're so busy moving forward in life, so a lot of times our ears actually aren't above our shoulders. So just moving your chin back slightly, closing your eyes, and getting a sense of how it feels to be all nicely stacked up. Feeling your feet nice and firmly on the ground. And with your eyes closed, focusing back in on your breath. And just noticing how your breath moves your body ever so slightly. Noticing as you inhale, maybe the top of your head rising up. And as you exhale, feeling yourself sinking back down into your feet. Beautiful. Let's flutter our eyes open. Bringing our hands to our heart center again. We're going to inhale, reach the arms all the way up towards the sky. bringing the palms together and making a little steeple with your index finger. We're going to inhale, reaching those fingers up a little bit higher, keeping your feet nice and solid. And then as you exhale, slowly going over towards the right, keeping your feet equally balanced, breathing into that space, and then coming back to center, taking a moment here, and then again, reaching those arms up a little higher as you inhale, and we'll slowly come over to the left. Breathing into that space, feeling both feet nice and balanced. Good, and then slowly coming back to center. Letting your arms just float down, letting your fingers rain down. Ah, beautiful. We're gonna come to the top of the mat, so I'm gonna turn this way. And coming back into our mountain pose, if you're not there already, standing up nice and tall, feeling your feet nice and solid. Let's bring our hands to our heart center. And from here, we're gonna slide the left leg back. And making sure you have enough space, so you wanna have your feet far enough apart so that they feel nice and comfortable. Making any adjustments to this back foot so that your knee feels okay. And you want your hips facing forward. We're gonna come into Warrior One as we bend a little bit deeper into that front knee, feeling that back heel rooting down. And when you're ready, you can reach the arms all the way up towards the sky, breathing in, maybe looking up, feeling the power of this warrior. Maybe asking yourself today, what kind of warrior do I want to be? Do I want to be a warrior of peace and love, or a warrior just going to get your groceries? So hanging out here, feeling your feet nice and solid, feeling them rooting down into the mat. Beautiful, bringing your palms together and back down to your heart center. Let's bring our hands to our hips. We're gonna lift that back heel up, rotating it, and just do a little few bounces here. And then we're going to bring that left foot forward, coming back into our mountain pose. Taking a moment to settle, feeling the effects of our warrior on the left side. And then we'll do that same on the other. So bringing your hands to your heart center, taking that right leg and stretching it back, getting it into a comfortable position on this side, making sure your knee feels good, hips are facing forward, and then bending into that left knee, feeling nice and solid here, feeling those feet supporting you, gripping and holding you up. And then we'll reach the arms all the way up towards the sky, sinking in a little bit deeper. And while you're here, coming back to your breath, so as you breathe in, feeling yourself expanding up towards the sky, and as you exhale, feeling yourself sinking a little bit deeper into your feet. And then we'll bring the palms together again, back to our heart. Bringing your hands to your hips. Let's bring that right heel off the ground and gently bouncing a few times. And then we'll bring that right foot forward, coming back into our mountain pose. Taking a few breaths here. And then bringing your hands to your heart center. Let's take our feet out to the edges of our mat. Toes are on a 45 degree angle. Breathing into your belly. And then we're going to slowly bend the knees, making sure your knees are facing in the same direction as your toes. Bending into those knees. Squatting down, maybe sliding your hands onto your knees. We're going to ease our way back into our little froggy pose. So settling back down here, wherever you're at, wiggling in. Taking a few moments, letting your hips relax, feeling your feet supporting you. Maybe even using your elbows to push those knees away. Coming back to your breath. Beautiful. We'll bring our hands down to the floor and we're going to ease our way all the way down into our Shavasana or corpse pose. So stretching your legs out, letting your body gently relax. Arms resting by your sides with your palms facing up. Closing your eyes here. Feeling the loving support of the floor of Mother Earth. Feeling all those points that are touching the mat. Your heels, maybe your calves and your hips. Upper back, back of the neck. Elbows in the back of your hands. And as you inhale, just expanding your belly. As you exhale, feeling yourself relaxing and melting a little deeper into the mat. To integrate all of the postures. And while you're here, I'd like to share a poem with you from Dana Faulds. It's called Black Eyed Susan. It's all here in this single stalk of black-eyed Susans, two dozen small suns rising on a single stem. It's all here, the whole season of rain and dry day. A summer of sunlight, the waxing and the waning moon. Crickets, spiders, and butterflies with stained glass wings. It's all here, buds and roots, drawing earth blood up through stalk and shoots. Each blossom, a universe, no galaxy greater than the ring of golden petals joined at the dark center. Answers not found in the fresh face of the flowers are simply not worth seeking. Namaste. May you have a beautiful, sunshiny day.